If we said it, we meant it. We gon' keep it 100 offended. Don't tune in if you easily offended. Send the facts and I'm hitting the engine. If you wag, I'ma tell you you wag, homie. Ain't no dealing with gossip, it's facts only. He fought and I smell all the cat phony. You ballin' the salary cap phony. You in a perfect position to learn something. So sit back and pour up a burn something. We ain't out here to preach for the word coming. Ain't hearing from us, you ain't heard nothing. We got the block hot like we serve something. We cover the topic, don't swerve nothing. I'm one of them fresh off the curb youngest. That probably came up off herb selling. No telling. We out here setting the vibe. Logic Unplugged. What a good time to be alive. We up. Pouring up, dude filling up my cup. If you're looking for the truth, tune in to us. This is that real shit. They can't relate cause they know that we kill shit. Sky's the limit, ain't heard of a ceiling. Tell these execs nothing less than a million. That's on God.
Yo,
all I know is, man, niggas better keep that same motherfucking energy on camera. That's all the fuck I know, man.
This guy
fucking tried me. Fuck Dej Loaf, niggas. But welcome back. This is Logic Unplugged Podcast. It's Logic with two motherfucking G's, because that's just what the fuck we is. Let me get a round of applause, Rick, man. This is episode number 10, man. Episode number motherfucking 10, man. I've been drinking. I'm slurring off the Hen Rock right quick, man. Pause, you know what I'm saying? But how y'all feeling, man? Episode 10. How y'all feeling?
I'm hype. I'm back. I missed last week. I apologize.
Hype. Niggas who like Dej Loaf shouldn't use the word hype.
First of all, I like the song.
I'm just saying, man. Shout out to Dej Loaf, man. If you looking for a sperm donor, holler at me. Other than that, man, stay out the booth. But with that being said, man, I'm going to start to my left and the audience's right. Our co-host that I decided to bring back because I felt bad for her.
Oh, God.
She was hitting me up like, Ab, you know, I really fuck with the pod.
I'm going to block him right after this.
You know what I mean?
Anyway.
We got none other than Shay Elise, a.k.a. Miss Shay C Vibes. But how are you, sister?
I'm good. I'm glad to be back. I'm sad that I missed that episode. That hot box was fire, and I'm really, really sad about it. But that's cool. We back. Episode 10. So.
Episode 10. You know what I mean? We in here. We in chair. You know what I mean? How would Dej Loaf say it?
I don't really know. You got to ask.
Oh, okay. I'm just asking. You know what I mean? But over here to my right and the audience's left, we have none other than Matic Beats, a.k.a. Matic. A.K.A. the illest beat maker and producer coming up out of South Jersey. What's going on, brother?
What's going on, man? What's popping with you, bro?
You tell me, man. You out here moving and shaking and moving.
Ain't shit, man. Like, you know what I mean? We making moves. Got my boy Dose here, you know. We about to promote his project coming out at the end of the month. We're going to get to him, man.
We're going to get to him. Pause. Him. You know what I mean?
But, you know, a little bit about me, you know what I'm saying? You know, I'm making moves. I got some things going on for the new project, but we going to talk a little bit
another new
that.
Project already again? Another you just one. Dropped it. So you out here trying to, you out here grinding.
Yeah, we, you know, that's what we do over here at the Logic Unplugged.
I mean, that's what I'm saying, man.
Network, you feel me?
Yeah, ooh, Logic Unplugged. Ooh.
Plug the unplug.
You know what people at Logic, network, baby. You know what co-hosts do? They go to Cowtown and buy new motherfucking coffee tables, man. They buy new coffee tables, man. Big enough for the... Let me get a round of applause for the new coffee table, Rick. Let me get a round of applause, man.
This nigga is hilarious.
If you want
I
the illest...
No new coffee table, man, over here.
If you want the illest, best in pre-owned farmer's market coffee tables, man, holla at Woodstown. Go out there to Cowtown, man. But
I might have to slide, though.
But as the audience can see, man, to my left, man, we have a two-time guest. Our very first guest of the podcast. Our very first guest to bless the hot box. Pause.
That's not pausable. A hot box is actually.
Relax. Okay. You know what is pausable? Dej Loaf's whole fucking career.
Oh my God, that's what is pausible. Save that for
that's what it is.
I love you, man.
But, yeah, you know what I mean? But we have none other than Central New Jersey's own Dose Do Money. What's going on, brother, man? Let me get a round of applause for Dose Do Money, man. Let me get a round of applause.
Out of Jersey, man. The Garden, you know what I mean? Middlesex County, Mama, Somerset Union, all
Shout
of Jersey,
out.
Man.
Yeah, man.
Central Jersey, the building.
Man. Yeah, man, definitely. Hold on, did I miss my plug?
And by the way, By the way, Dej Loaf, we love you. We just had a debate.
Dej Loaf, if you don't know who the fuck I am, I'm Abdul Hamid, a.k.a. me, the Jersey Slugger, a.k.a. Mr. A56, don't take no shit, a.k.a. 609, it's our time, a.k.a. I done ran the fuck a.k.a.'s, man.
Mother Styles.
Slide in my DM, holler at me, Dej Loaf. You know what I mean? I ain't say she wasn't bad. I didn't say she wasn't bad.
She's fine.
Man, but but with that being said, man, all four of us being from Jersey and us being over here in Jersey, man, it was opening weekend for high school football out here, man. And around the corner, we had a death of a dynasty, a death of a program. They lost their head coach to a college program. They brought in a crack-ass cracker that don't know how to deal with black athletes, so that's a fact. You had fucking Timber Week. In case y'all don't know, y'all probably don't. We're only going to stay on this for a couple seconds, but we have a Timber Week alumni over here. And shout out to Roderick Boyd, man. Shout out to his son, Deuce, man. He played a hell of a game.
Let's talk about Timber Creek.
No. Let's talk about Timber Week. They lost 21-0 to fucking Williamstown. Oh. Man, look, yo, Rick, let me get a fucking gunshot off these motherfuckers, for the record, man.
Isn't it true that Williamstown is now 4-0?
What happened?
True? Aren't they 4-0 now?
What are you talking about? Oh, they are? What are you talking about? No, this was the opening weekend, brother.
Never mind, y'all. I'm space.
Man, yo, listen, kids, I'm just going to say this right now. Just say no to drugs. We used to have this thing back in the 90s called the D.A.R.E. program, man. Right? you just say no to
man,
drugs.
Man, you know damn well D.A.R.E. was getting high, bro.
Everybody.
Yeah. Them niggas that came through and gave you this little... Like,
high school kids that came to elementary school and all that.
You got this little, like...
They used
like,
to come with the little... Oh,
we gonna come here.
The joint before
they had these mugs performing, and they had a mug come out dressed up.
Let us be off.
He be the highest one and shit on the space cakes. You know what I'm saying? He was on the space cakes and all that shit.
But I just want to give a big shout-out, man, to Dubtown and still say, man, shout-out to Mozzarella Melted, man. Shout-out to Larry Rakes, man. You know what I mean? Timber Week got their ass bust. Pause.
Bro, but Timber Creek is a legendary fucking school when it comes to sports,
Keyword was,
bro.
Just like Dej Loaf's career.
It doesn't matter. We're the Patriots out this bitch. Yo,
Timber Week reminds me of fucking Dej Loaf's career. Used to be something, man. But moving right along, man, speaking of football, man, we had a program, a youth football program out here in Jersey. They call it midget football. In South Jersey, they call it midget football, which is very derogatory, by the way.
It is. It's
not politically correct. Shout out to the small people in the room. Shout out to Shacy Vibes. But
I'm not alone today, but anyway.
But about 15, 20 minutes from here on 295 South, on our way back to Delaware, there's a town right next to Paulsboro called Gibbstown. And over the weekend, you had the sophomore age group, which consists of 8 and 9-year-olds. The coach and certain kids decided to take a knee, I guess even with their parents' permission, during the national anthem, and they protested. And the board took it upon themselves of that program, which is they're not white, they're crack-ass crackers, calling what the fuck they is. They voted on these 8 and 9-year-old kids and these coaches to be suspended for the rest of the year.
The year.
That's a fucking shame.
It's been going viral on Facebook. It was in the Courier Post, the local paper out here. They kind of touched on it. Pause. But it needs to be blown up even more. Like I reached out to my peoples. Her mom runs the NAACP in Gloucester County. She says they was already on top of it and dealing with shit. But they took a knee, peaceful protest. And mind you, there's two neighboring towns, if anybody in South Jersey knows. Paulsboro is 99.9% black.
Exactly.
You got Gibbstown, which is 99.9% redneck. They're next to each other. Paulsboro opted out of football for the season because of COVID. So all their players went to the white town. Mm-hmm. So the black players protested. And the white board decided to suspend them. Now, I'll credit the president of this program. He's an older white gentleman. He was the only one to vote no. And when they voted to suspend the kids and the players, this older white gentleman, I forget his name, but he resigned because he didn't agree with what they were doing. But the rest of these crack-ass, cracker, redneck motherfuckers off of exit 17, 16, 15, Gibbstown, off of 295 South, y'all should be ashamed of yourselves suspending 8 and 9-year-old fucking kids and coaches for a peaceful protest.
That's ridiculous.
And the reason why these motherfuckers can get away with this bullshit is because of 45's punk ass. You know, the nigga that just got fucking COVID. Yeah, I'm out of order right now, but we're going to talk about that shit now.
It's fine, because he back out in these streets.
Yeah,
he
ain't nothing fucking happened. Motherfucker get diagnosed with fucking COVID and leave the hospital.
Wake up, everybody.
Yeah, definitely.
That's all I gotta say about that.
I don't know if he really had it or not, but yeah, either way, it's the wrong example being set. Right. Period.
Super
that
wrong.
It's just showing you how not seriously he didn't take it. You know what I'm right. saying? People die from that.
Right.
Are you driving around waving at people?
And let's just right. say the shit is true.
I don't like this shit at all.
I don't even know if the shit is true because this nigga lies so much.
Exactly.
Might but let's just say it's the United States Channel. You know what I'm saying? It's entertainment pretty much.
Really
this
is.
But it's a fuck, man. We a fucking laughing stock of the world right now.
Our country has turned into The Apprentice. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's literally that show.
Either that or it turned into fucking Dej Loaf's career where nobody gives a fuck about this shit.
No one was willing to try them. No one was willing to try them.
I didn't even know he was going there with
that. So that's why they playing the spectacle.
I don't know who had a word. Because look, to me, Dej Loaf been in quarantine for about 5 motherfucking years.
I can't stand it.
Because she, I mean... What?
Yo, her, that song was thing, hard man. That she Let's came out with, that. But I agree with you. I haven't heard
She just
nothing,
dropped
you know?
Some tough shit on, I believe, what, not Benny the Butcher, who was it? Not
Conway. She was on
Conway's
she
album.
Was on Conway shit,
that shit
yeah.
was hard, pause. But she can't release nothing else.
Bro, you have to admit, though, like, her contribution to the culture.
My fault. We rambling. We drink. We was arguing behind the scenes,
at
man.
The same
she,
time.
She birthed a lot of styles in this era.
In her era,
can't
yeah.
deny it, dog.
Look, I agree, but I don't like the style she birthed.
How many,
not talking
how many
about
melodic
96?
Niggas did you have before Try Me?
You know what I'm saying?
How like, many melodic niggas weird, did you bro. Have before Try Me, dog?
That shit weird, man.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought the Dej Loaf fan.
Let me hear
something.
Your real voice, my G. Let me hear you. Let me hear you rap, my G.
Shout out to Dej Loaf, by the way, man. Shout out to Detroit.
Like,
you know what I mean?
Man, no, shout out to Detroit. Just don't
like
shout out to Dej Loaf.
Girls
man.
Melodic. Bro, hell yeah. I like. Dumb. I love hearing females I mean, melodic, but,
yeah, but
my nigga,
what y'all doing?
I don't want to hear you melodic.
But once again, man, shout out to Dej Loaf. If you need any help with anything, slide in my DMs. I'll definitely respond, man. But, you know, but like, wrapping up on 45. You know what I mean? How do we even get the Dej Loaf? You know what I mean? But yeah, I don't know if the nigga got the shit or not. If he does, he's being very irresponsible. His team came out and said he is going to do the debate next week. This nigga moving reckless. This nigga doing drive bys fresh out the hospital. Why he was supposed to be in the hospital? Like this nigga is like.
He taking pictures, revealing, taking off his mask and shit.
I'm not going to speak about the shit
on here.
I'm like,
this is some fucking funny ass shit. This is like.
I'm not going to speak about the shit here over the phone or text message, but I was wishing some harmful shit.
I think a lot of people
block.
Were.
They gonna block episode 10.
Everybody,
man.
Everybody's
even
gonna get a letter from the government in your Gmail account.
But I think we
you know who probably got a letter
feelings.
From the government? Dej Loaf probably got a letter because she ain't dropped a motherfucking hit in 5 motherfucking years. But that's neither here nor there,
bro. We tapping retired. On feelings though. That's but, how everybody feeling.
But speaking of peaceful protests and 45 making these crack ass crackers have a voice, and you know the young football players down in Gibbstown taking a peaceful protest, man. You know, still talking about the football topic, man. We had, man, shout out to the, let me give a round of applause, Rick, man. We had the New York Giants who are 0-4 they 0-4 or 0-5?
Yeah, shut up. You know what we can
You a Giants fan?
Oh, you know That's what? Oh, you know what's crazy? Y'all gonna laugh. When I was talking about 4-0, I actually thought about the Giants. That's what I mean.
Oh, my
That's
God.
What, listen, man. Shout out to the New York Giants, man, for being 0-4, man. Let me get a round of applause, man.
Fuck out of here.
Shout out, real quick shout out, man, to the Eagles, man. We won 2-1 and in first motherfucking place, bitch ass niggas.
All right. But, there's nothing to be proud of in the NFC.
With that being said, man, you got the 0-4 New York football Giants. That squared off against the L.A. Rams.
This shit was stupid.
Listen, man, and there was some tension out there.
Pause. And it didn't even belong there. Well,
I mean,
I saw what happened before.
I mean, there was some previous tweets of, you know, you don't think I'm going to check them when I see them. And if people don't know what we're talking about, man, we're talking about Jalen Ramsey and Golden Tate.
First of all,
what's
he got
going on?
Smacked. Did y'all see him get smacked?
What is going on with this shit?
Well, hold on. Let me catch the audience up to speed right quick, man. You had Jalen Ramsey of L.A., cornerback, and you had Golden Tate. I think he's like a fourth stringer now.
Are we serious?
They fought after the game. Was that after the game?
It was after the game. But
they fought because Jalen Ramsey left Golden Tate's sister. She don't even look that bad.
First of all, he left her while she was pregnant. There's definitely more to this.
Pregnant chicks get left every day, bitch.
He didn't like how
he
did. No
disrespect to the pregnant women in the room.
He couldn't wait.
He did wait. So let me tell you, first of all, First of all, niggas got smacked on the field. You feel me? Like, so that's
but why he couldn't wait.
First of all, you seen the nigga before that game. That's how I feel. You done seen the nigga before the game.
But that's your job.
So you trying to say he stuck?
That's your job.
Publicity stuff.
Once you're not away from your job, I would have smacked that nigga. That's
what happened though. They said because also he left homeboy's sister for like a stripper.
Quick story, man.
I love my strippers. So that's
I shouldn't put my personal business out there, but I left my significant other for a stripper when she was pregnant. I mean, but we back together now. That's all that counts.
We're about to lose no all problem of if our it's a viewership. Stripper or a
librarian. It don't matter.
Strippers are the best thing to ever grace the face. Strippers need love too, Sway. Strippers need love too.
That's why you love that show.
I love my strippers. I'm just saying.
What was that show called?
P-Valley.
P-Valley. Oh, P-Valley. That's why you let it.
I love
shit.
P. And my crooked letter, man. Pussy Valley, her, man.
But that's but he did wait for him after the game though.
But I'm gonna tell you right now though, man. But how do y'all feel, man? Like, do y'all feel that that should have? Me personally, if it was that serious, you could have been dealt with that shit off the field.
That's what I'm saying.
How long ago did it happen when he left her?
Wasn't it like last year or something?
So like even now, I can see now if there's other reports that do come out, maybe like, yo, this might be like the fourth time these niggas rumbled. I could see that like maybe the brother's just holding on to some shit. You know what I'm saying? But if this is the first altercation, then you styling the profile for these cameras. It like you're kind of acting like a Dej Loaf ass nigga.
My nigga. No, but you know what the thing is, man? I saw what happened on the field, and they said it was two occurrences. Before the actual fight, it seemed like dude who left. Who was the dude that left? Ramsey?
Ramsey left. And I ain't gonna lie, I looked at old boy's sister, and she ain't all that. I would have probably left the bitch too. Excuse my language.
That ain't all that matters, but still.
Man, when Ramsey, I'm just saying.
But when Ramsey,
light skin. I don't even like light skin chicks. That's my light skin. But she
really
black
want
though.
Us to my do another pecans, episode, guys.
My caramel butterscotch.
I'm sorry. Shout out to Studio BA56 because technically we're on our second episode of the night.
No, but for real. What I'm saying is, Ramsey, they said that there was one play where Ramsey tried to tackle Tate, and Tate kind of did the smooth. He did the smooth, like, you know what I mean? He did the smooth Michael Jackson move. And shit. And then
so hold on, you bigging Tate up for being an actual football player?
So
right
then
now?
He was just like,
he's telling the backstory.
They said that was significant. I was reading the USA Today article, and they were saying that was a significant turn of events because afterwards he was like, yo, I'm gonna get this nigga. You know what I'm saying? Because afterwards he's like, yo, he mad because I listened. You know
Ramsey
mean?
Smacked Tate,
like that.
Wasn't it? Well, no, who smacked who?
They're saying that Golden Tate. They're saying that Jalen Ramsey threw the first blow. And then after the game, Jalen Ramsey was waiting outside the Giants locker room.
That's crazy shit. But this is a year after. Like,
I don't know if it's a year per se. Don't get me lying, but
y'all making all that money doing that? Like,
No. But you're dealing with personal as a brother.
It is,
but you're dealing with feelings and emotions too. Like you're talking about your sister. Imagine your little sister getting left while she's pregnant. So even because I've been in situations like that, maybe not directly with my sister, but where like. I don't give a fuck. I'm willing to throw it all away.
Well, maybe as a man, he thought that was the most mature way for him to handle it. You know where I really can't hit this nigga? On the football field.
On the field.
So if I go for him right now, I'm going to lose my job.
Because honestly, I didn't know about this story until.
He wasn't the one who hit him.
It is a point.
He wasn't the one who caused the aggression, though. Tate was the one who was dodging. He was the wide receiver.
Yeah.
So Tate is the dude whose sister got left. So he's the one who's feeling the type of way. But he's still the one juking. Ramsey, I feel like...
Oh, let me
like
see the juke move again. Let me show you. You used to play?
Street football as a kid, you know what I mean? But when it comes to that, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like Ramsey, he's just like, you know what I mean? He's just playing the game. Tate may have felt the type of way, but still, if it took a year to get to that, like, you know what I'm saying?
Y'all making that money. If it was you, do you have a sister?
Y'all were probably mad about some other... Of course I do.
No, so if it was your sister and you played pro ball... I would assume you would have addressed that way before a year, correct?
I would have been like, hey, bro, you know what I'm saying? Let's talk real quick. Let me get an understanding as to where your mind's at, leaving my sister in that, in that place in her life, you know what I mean? And then we would proceed as such. I wouldn't wait a whole year, you know what I mean, going to my place of business because football is a place of business, you know what I mean? I'm not going to go into the field. That's your office. I'm not going to go into the office and start, you know what I mean, causing ruck.
Right, that's what I was saying.
You don't do that off
the
field.
If your finances and investments is good, though.
And get suspended for what? That's for attention, or maybe he was mad about something else before. That's the only conclusion I could come up with. You know what I mean? And then use that as an excuse. Because
now look at it. We talking about this shit's like a spectacle. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely was corny. We already lost. Like, this shit.
You know what I'm saying?
And shout out, man. Once again, man, we're going to move right along, man. But once again, man, shout out to the 1-2-1 first place Philadelphia Eagles, man. Shout out to the Eagles, man. Shout out to the Eagles, man.
I'll take it for now, man. You know what I mean? I'll take it for now.
But staying in sports, man, a lot of people gave this brother some flack. Pause. Just sound like a pausable moment. But, King motherfucking James. So he got some flack for walking off the court with 10 seconds left, not shaking hands. Me personally, I think he's wearing his heart on his sleeve, and I don't think he did anything wrong. There's nothing wrong with what he did, especially with being someone who runs. I am a vice president of a youth football organization, vice president. I've coached for current NFL players. You have our engineer, Roderick Boyd, who has a son who was a D1, going to be a current D1 athlete and coach NFL athletes. All that sportsmanship honestly doesn't exist. That exists to people outside of the sports realm. Don't nobody give a shit about sportsmanship? We don't preach sportsmanship. He wore his heart on his fucking sleeve. This nigga was pissed off. They was losing. Get the fuck out of here, man. I commend him for doing that.
Not just that. This is a story that y'all be watching TV for. If it didn't happen, y'all be complaining about where's our story in basketball. That's what they be offering now. They don't even care about stats. They just want the story when they watch on TV.
Shay over there look like
I have a question. That's all. I just have a question. So 10 years from now, when we get his documentary and he's sitting there and he's like, oh, pissed off. This person did this. So I walked off the court. Is that when y'all are going to say, yeah, because he was always a brat. That was a bratty move. He was soft for that, blah, 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 like y'all did Jordan.
I never called him soft.
I'm not saying you ever have. I'm saying the same way everybody Jordan, watched the Jordan I wish documentary there was so like, yeah, he was soft for that. That was whack. He did the same thing.
I think Jordan is a stone cold bitch.
Okay. I'm asking, is that what people are going to say?
Well, you always going to have your LeBron haters. I don't understand the LeBron hate. You don't have to be LeBron don't have to be your favorite player, but acknowledge greatness when it's in front of your fucking face. That's my whole thing.
He's a great player, but he holds the same culture as every great player. Wanting to his ego always overcome the player.
Yeah, like and
Jordan's ego overcame him.
Yeah, when you invest
LeBron's ego overcame him.
When you invest so much and you train in this stuff,
he feel like he that nigga.
Not even that, you invest into winning and this is your livelihood. And you got none of us been in this position since the time we were fucking 9, 10 years old talking about we the next greatest thing. Like your whole family's depending on you. And then you just get blown at. Like, we can't sit here and say what we would do in that heart of the moment. But I've not shaken hands after the game, and I ain't get reprimanded for it. Maybe by my coach was like, yo, you still need to shake your hand. But then I was also pulled aside. Like, I can't blame you.
Mm-hmm. But he wasn't whining, though.
He wasn't whining. He walked off the court.
Because
he might have done some fuck shit if he stayed on the court. You know what I'm saying? And people would have been memeing him. He gave a fake-ass handshake, rolled his eyes, would have said some dumb shit to the press. Like, fuck it,
man. He still took it like a G. You know what I mean?
It's competitive. Why the fuck do I want to shake your hand if you just beat me? Like, why? I never understood that. Like, why? For what?
I was curious what role
he's not like throwing punches in the air and shit and whining.
That's like me being a one-hit wonder from the city of Detroit.
I understand it. That shit's a hard thing to do. And wanting to shake
hands with another, like,
it's a hard fucking thing to do when you wanted to win so bad, yo. You don't want to shake that motherfucking hand.
But do y'all think it was poor sportsmanship, though?
You don't want to do that.
I don't feel like it was poor sportsmanship.
I want to know if everybody's going to hold the same stance later on in life.
But see, my whole thing is, when don't do it after every game. Like, don't do it on the exhibition. You know what I mean?
But this is
my whole thing. LeBron ain't the only one. Tom Brady has been on film several times not shaking hands. Where's the same backlash for Tom Brady? He's been on. I think when the Eagles won the Super Bowl, he didn't shake hands. Then
you know
the NBA
go
right
is
off
a way more personal game, you know, when it comes to personality.
Yeah, because it's smaller people. The roster's only like 10, 11 people.
They be concentrated in depth on that personality of the the player.
Yeah, man. It's just crazy, man. Shout out to King motherfucking James, the greatest basketball player of all fucking time. Don't give a fuck what y'all know.
I would have to say Kobe Bryant.
Who?
Kobe Bryant.
Well, rest in peace. Kobe
rest in peace. You know what I'm saying?
For
rest
me, that's
AI.
Allen Iverson, best player of all time.
AI's top three.
He best at all time.
Kobe AI.
Did you watch our episode about this last week? And I was like,
huh? Did you watch our episode last week?
Who's
episode? Our episode. Oh, whose episode?
Yeah, wait.
No, I thought you said, did you
okay,
watch
that
their
was our
episode.
Okay.
I didn't hear you say
that's
our.
That's it for Dose Do Money.
I thought you meant.
Cop his album along with Dej Loose.
Oh, my God, bro. No, bro, I thought you meant.
We were talking about AI. Like AI is my favorite basketball player of all time. But I acknowledge he's not the GOAT. To me, LeBron is the best of all time. But AI is my personal favorite. It's just like what rap, like I was comparing it to, is I think Hov is the GOAT. But my personal favorite rapper of all time is Styles P.
Okay.
Respect, respect.
You know what I mean?
Respect, respect.
I like smoking wet. Well, I used to, allegedly.
Right.
Smoke wet and rob niggas. Nah. Like you can Google my name, Abdul Hamid Chase, on njdoc.com, and all my charges will pop up.
Anyway.
Nah, but moving right along, though. But speaking of people in their feelings, because they said LeBron was in his feelings walking off the court, man.
Your transitions are getting worse.
How my transition? It's because I've been drinking. Maybe if my co-hosts don't miss fucking weeks. Medic, have you ever missed an episode?
Nah.
Okay.
No,
I'm just going to say, man.
Not yet.
Okay. I'm just not yet. Okay.
But y'all might catch me on the Zoom on the next one.
Oh, shit, man. But we
I might have a fucking beach hat on or some shit.
Oh, that's
shit.
Fucked up.
But we have Dr. Dre won the initial settlement. This isn't, people was getting this confused with his whole settlement.
That was wild.
They're getting confused with this whole
clap.
Settlement. A gentleman clap. But she was talking some reckless shit. Excuse the ladies in the room, because I don't like saying the B word. But this bitch wanted $1.5 million a month.
Said it mad hard.
A month. What the fuck could you do with $1.5? And your kids are grown. Kids is grown.
Yeah.
What the fuck is you going to do with $1.5 million a month?
Open a grocery store, some chains.
No, she's going to buy a bunch of designer.
Yo, what's going on?
She's
going to
stun on these
bro.
Bitches. That's what she going to do.
I don't know. That shit was kind of crazy. Hey.
What's popping? That makes me feel like, what the fuck's up with this divorce with her? What's up with her, bro, to ask for that money?
How long? Are you able to look at? How long were they married for? Like, how long did they know each other?
Yo, that shit was 25
years.
So with that being said, like, it leads me into the topic of,
prenups.
Do you think, prenups, yeah. Do you think they should have signed a prenup? But, like, you're talking about 20 years. Now, Dre's been around over 20, so he was already pretty popping.
Yeah, he was
like
way popping before.
So,
30 years, 30 plus.
Do you think that they should have signed a prenup?
Hell yeah.
Woo!
Hell
yeah.
Woo!
We getting spicy.
I'm prenup gang, you know what I mean?
Like, bang, bang, prenup gang?
For real. Hell
yeah. What's the extent of prenup? Do both parties sign their own prenup? Because why is that not a thing?
But you see,
they do. I know a lot. I know more females in regular day society. I know more females that make male sign prenups.
What's the point?
I know a lot
of
professional females.
I'm gonna give you a point on why, because look at Chris Rock. He got a prenup, but his wife waited. Right? She waited when that shit ended and then divorced him, so that shit was void.
There's a statute.
There's statutes on prenups.
But I'm sweating. I feel like I'm.
You can fuck around and do a prenup, but all the girl gotta do is get a lawyer. And they'll just instruct her on how to move.
I don't really.
Chris
then,
Rock
that's
went
still
still
the question of if
had
you
to
feel
give
like
his
you
wife
have
half.
To sign a prenup.
So
though,
he might as well not even do it.
So if is that's how you feel like if you have to sign a prenup, why
you might as well make arrangements and keep an amicable order and shit.
Wait, you're asking
a buck.
You're asking why even get married?
Can you get that for me, please?
Yeah,
man?
Why even sign?
If you a star,
paperwork. Why enter in? Excuse me, those. Why even enter? Yeah, why enter in this contract? Because it really is a contract. All marriages is a paper contract.
Exactly. I have a perfect answer because marriage, I forgot the specific interview, but marriage is a business in its own. Nick Cannon said that.
It
marriage,
really is.
Marriage is an
institution.
Says
the man who don't own his own shit, but go ahead.
It is, though. It's an institution.
Yeah, no, it is.
You know what I mean? And
you're signing a legal document saying you guys are legally bound to each other.
Yeah.
Exactly. So it's the same thing as going into, it's not the same thing, but it's in the same realm as in going into like, a shareholder to be in. You
exactly.
Know what I mean? Therefore, just protect yourself. You can't tell the future, and you're not that other person. You know what I'm saying?
I think so as long as the nigga ain't
a heart at any time.
I think as long as the nigga ain't a fuck nigga and don't fuck the. Now, do I think she should get something? Absolutely right, but I'm all against staying out of the court system. I'm all against staying
all against
out. I don't believe in the court system as far as when it comes to divorce and everything.
I agree.
So,
I don't have
but
any
like, now
you
don't get me wrong.
Arrangements.
Niggas do some fuck shit as far as like, and then you know, unfortunately, females get cut out of shit. Like, all right, yeah, I'm going to trust you either with the kids or whatever. And then they wind up getting fucked over.
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
But, no, yes, I understand we're married and stuff. But just because we're married, unless you personally help me build this business, motherfucker, this shit ain't yours. Why the fuck are you leaving with half of my shit? Yo, I have a coworker right now. He subscribed to this shit. I'm not going to say your name. This nigga pays $950 a month for one kid for child support. And then,
for one?
Oh, listen, listen. Then another $3,500 a month in alimony.
Listen, damn. And listen.
And we work a regular 9-to-5 out this bitch. And mind you, the child support is with another woman. The alimony, they don't even have a kid together.
And listen, let me say this, all right, from my own experience, you know what I mean? I was last in jail in 2015.
Oh, shit.
And I'm telling you, when it comes to that, a majority of the people that you see out there in jail are a lot of individuals, at least the ones who are there for the short term, are individuals who owe child care. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And that's its own institution. So why are we always applauding that, even though it should be? Child care is appropriate and essential, you know what I mean? But why are we applauding that, but looking down on prenups?
Crazy.
It's very similar.
Yeah. So let me ask you this, Shay, because you said, why even get married then, correct?
Yeah.
So do you not feel that you can love someone and still sign a prenup? Or someone could approach you? Like, say you're in love and you found your soulmate and they ask you to sign a prenup. Is that going to you, do you think that's going to change things?
Yeah, for me. Either we're both going to sign a prenup, I will have mine and you will have yours. So that way we can both feel protected.
Yeah.
Otherwise, if you recognize that marriage is an institution, I'm not going into it signing a prenup. You know what I'm saying? Because that means you understand it, but you still have your stipulations about it. So why don't we just not enter into that institution if we have to put this extra piece
of paperwork on it? Would you ever be open to marrying with a prenup, even if both of y'all signed it?
That's the resentment that comes in to where a girl gets you later.
You're making a lot of sense.
If both of us are signing it, that's different. I'm not against both. If you coming on, if you had that energy in the beginning.
I'm saying into the mic, pause.
Oh, my bad. I was saying, I agree with what you're saying. But at the same time, this is my response to that. Like, marriage is its own institution. So, you know what I mean? We going into this oath. It's pretty much an oath. You know what I'm saying? So why are we even entertaining negating that oath later? Because what's the point of even making that oath to begin with, essentially, right? At the same time, that's true. But it's like, at the same time, there's always someone who can have a change of heart. I'm not saying that, you know what I mean, that that's the right thing to do, but who knows?
I'm in total agreement.
It's like a condom.
I see a prenup as a condom.
Thing.
You know what I'm saying? It's like a financial condom.
And this is what I would say. I agree with Shay is, my whole thing is, even, I'm just going to say, I'm speaking from a man's point of view. Even, let's just say I'm an entertainer or an athlete. And just because you may be a stay-at-home mom or stay-at-home wife, I'm all with, if I sign a prenup, then if you sign a prenup, then I'll sign one too. Because I'm all with that.
Yeah, and because even really though... people really be mad about that. Oh, no, but I'm cool gave you a that. Prenup. You gave me a prenup?
Because you know how many of these sisters and women are coming up off of who they're married to, who they have a kid with, so I'm cool with that. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you made that name off of me, but I'm cool because guess what? At the end of the day, I still made my coins. If I fuck it up, then that's on me.
That means we both respect each other as a business. If that's how we move in, you feel me? Like, yeah. I'm not coming for your coins. If we going to do this, we going to do this off the rail, and you not coming for mine. Like, right. That's how I would look at it, by us both being comfortable signing a prenup. Like, cool. We not trying to fuck in this to fuck each other money up.
But that you know, the big question is this. What do you feel about marriage? How do you feel like if a dude came up to you and said this?
I like talking about money. Look, if a dude came to you and was like, look, I'm fucking with you.
I love you, but I can't get married. I don't want to get married. I don't like how the system set up.
I don't believe in marriage.
I
want
to have kids with you, but I don't want to get married.
I don't believe in marriage.
What do you feel about that?
That depends on the person. Because I don't necessarily know if I'm going to get married. If I'm okay, I'm okay if I don't end up getting married. As long as I know I'm with the right person for the rest of my life, I'm okay with that.
I don't.
There are plenty of people who have started families and have yet to get married. Like, they have three kids.
My whole
I'd like to, but I don't have to, because people get married to the wrong person more than people get married to the right person.
We might have to edit. I'm going to show y'all the message. I'm going to tell you like this, man. What I tell my kids too is, man, don't rush into marriage. I don't think nobody should get married. If you get married, there's nothing wrong with marriage. I think it's beautiful. I think it's not for everyone. Mm-hmm.
Agreed.
If you get married, I don't think you should get married under the age of 30.
Yeah, we got to get like the white people more. They don't get married or have kids till they like 36 and up.
I don't know. I know some. I went to school with some white people that got married straight out of high. I know a lot of white people that got married straight out of high school.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, but it's 50-50.
It's either that or 36 and 37.
But even with the marriage thing, but it comes down to, see, I'm about to spin it off. I don't think, if you really are, take away the Western civilization things, because we're brainwashed to what Western civilization thinks.
Is marriage, yeah.
I don't think two people are meant to be with the same person for the rest of their fucking life.
I had this conversation recently.
I don't think that is normal. We look at it as normal because that's what we were brainwashed to fucking think.
It's kind of like a population control thing if you look at how the history is.
Because there's more female. That's why I'm Muslim. So in Islam, and people are like, oh, you guys are allowed to have four wives. But if you look at reason why, it's because even back then in the Quran, it says is there's more women than males, and to keep the women from homosexuality, that's why you marry more women. That's the core purpose of it. A lot of people don't know that. But me personally, outside of Islam, without getting into a religious aspect, I just think it's crazy to be with the same person for the rest of your life. That's just me personally.
You got commitment issues.
Listen, I'm legally married.
Yeah, I know I do.
I feel like
my wife. She watches every week. I'm just saying.
And shout out to my woman. You know what I mean?
I'm like an alien right when it comes to that. I got issues with that shit.
But this is my own opinion on that. I agree with you when it comes to that. However, I feel as if, like, you know what I'm saying, people should still have the choice if they want to be married or not, be monogamous or not. But at the same time,
I'm not knocking those who do it.
Yeah, I know that. But what I'm saying is to agree with you and champion what you're saying. You know what I'm saying? Like, when it comes to, like, essentially people being either polyamorous, like, I support people's choices. Like, there are plenty of successful polyamorous situations. Like, I dated a girl who was polyamorous a few years ago, and she was one of the happiest, most at peace people that you ever met. And she had two boyfriends. I was just, you know, her side nigga to them two niggas.
But that's some real shit. You know what I mean? She's cheating
on two niggas with me. You know what I'm saying? But that's its own other story. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know some polyamory. You know I mean? I got a polyamorous situation.
But still, like, she was happy. She said her relationship, even though she was cheating on them niggas, like, she was happy. She was saying that they were, dead ass. She was saying that, you know, they were happy. They were a unit. You know what I mean? They would hang out, go on dates together.
Yeah. She was like, she got to have it.
But that's what, Nola Darling, that's what she was.
Who's Nola Darling?
She's got to have it.
Exactly what
likely
she was.
She's got to have it.
Yeah, but
she was polyamorous.
She had them niggas come through for Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah. At the end, they all got it in at the end of shit.
They came through for Thanksgiving.
That's the only
and
part
shit.
You remember. Hey. I can't say
it's not knocking monogamy, because my thing is, again, just like the marriage, I think it's beautiful. I think that's fine. I just don't like the way society pushes everything down our throat saying you have to get married.
Right.
You have to accept this, even with the LGBTQ community. All right. I love my gays. Pause. Not meaning it like that.
That was the greatest thing I've ever heard in my life.
He said, but,
I love my gays.
I love my gays.
Listen, I ain't trying to get canceled because I know that's the wrong community to fuck up with. Pause.
Oh,
again.
My gosh.
But don't force the shit down. Or like, my nigga, I'm not even ready to talk to my regular kids about sex, let alone turning on an episode of something and two motherfuckers is kissing. Two niggas is kissing. There's nothing wrong with that. But don't tell me I have to accept it, and if I don't accept it, then I'm homophobe. No, I'm not. I'm cool. You can do what you do. Homophobe is when you beat a nigga up or kill a nigga over that shit, and you just go out and speak against it. I'm cool.
I think that's where people get it mixed up. We don't all have to be of the same lifestyle, and I think that's what they're imposing.
I think we're such in a lifestyle time now where you say something, you have to. Like, you speak out against it, it's like, it's always, even like with the Black Lives Matter stuff. I'm the biggest Black Lives Matter supporter and protester and everything. Like, if you say something, I'm going to preach it to you. Now, once you know the truth and you say X, Y, and Z, then I'm like, all right, yeah, you a racist-ass motherfucker. You know what I mean? But, like, just bringing the full circle, man, with the monogamy and everything with that. Listen, man, and the marriage is, like, to each his own. I just don't like how it's forced upon us on this civilization out here, Western civilization. It's like a lot of people are like, yo, you have to accept it. And I just don't think, just me personally, just ending out on that note is,
date someone who likes you. Because that's what people don't do either. Date someone who actually fucking likes you and that you like.
Yeah, man. That's a start. Or just go out there and just do what you do.
Oh, my gosh. I didn't know where he was going with that.
Do what you do. Go out there, man, and just do what you do. You know someone else who did what they did?
Oh. Yo, please.
Here we go. Who? I mean, man, you had this nigga. I mean, you had Drake, man. He went out there and he dropped some bars in the new song.
Oh, that was so bad.
With 21 Savage and SZA. Shout out to SZA.
Shout out to Danny Jersey too, because she always has on a Drake t-shirt every time she in here.
She do got a Drake t-shirt. She's the
biggest fan ever.
Shout out to Drake, man. Shout out to Champagne Poppy. I met you too. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm probably going to link up with you later or something. You know what I mean?
Bye.
But Champagne Poppy dropped a new song along with 21 Savage and Metro Bommin. And basically insinuated that him and SZA used to be a thing back in 2008. Now, SZA came out and said it wasn't 2008, it was 2009, because in 2008 she would have been a minor. He would have been on his Tiger shit. So why
did she even, like, help him out in that
situation? Oh, no. She was just clarifying the situation that she wasn't partaking in that. But this is the main thing of the story is why even bring it up? Now, the whole... speaking on your whole dick and everything going on Instagram. Listen, I don't give a fuck who you is. If you my man, I'm telling you if I hit or not. I don't give a fuck. I'm not going around telling the random nigga like, yo, you want to smash.
I'll do the same thing.
Females are worse than niggas. Females is worse than niggas.
Like, y'all do the same thing.
Females is way worse than niggas.
But that is Drake, though, man. He that's his brand.
But why now, though?
His brand is to tell you who he's fucking with. He was like, you know what? I did fuck with SZA back in 2008.
Every 5 years, he drops a name.
And she was kind of like.
Every 5 years, he drops a name. And we're like, damn, for real?
He'll fuck around and be like, yep, you know what? I did fuck with somebody in this time.
Honestly, though, I didn't hear the record. I didn't hear the record. I can visualize Drake, you know, on his smooth shit being like, you know.
He was on some smooth shit when he slid that shit on some smooth shit. He did.
You listened to the record?
Yeah, I heard it.
You listened to the record?
No, I read the lyrics.
You read the lyrics?
Yeah.
Do you have the lyrics punched up?
Yeah.
Hold on. Let me hear exactly what he said. Hold on. Shout out to her.
He slid that shit in there.
Shout out to her.
Obviously, everybody going to catch it. Everybody listen to what he says.
Shout out to our fifth best co-host.
The biggest artist, period, in the past, like, 15 years, to be honest with you.
Hold on. Shout out to our fifth best co-host over here punching up the lyrics right quick.
No, literally, I had it. I don't have it anymore. So, let's move on.
All right, anyhow.
JC vibes with the potions.
But let's get back. All right, she don't have the lyrics. So, let's say this, though.
Pretty much. Like.
Let's say this, though. Is it a thing within our community where niggas like to brag and boast of who they smash?
Oh, wait. Yeah. I found the lyrics because now I really want to. The nigga going to say, yeah, said she want to fuck to some SZA. Wait, because I used to date SZA back in 08. If you cool with it, baby, she can still play. So wait a minute. So that made it even worse. So you rapping about who you about to be fucking on, like, and she like, oh, play some this. And he like, oh, yeah, I used to fuck with her. Yeah, but if that's your shit. You know, put it on. Get the fuck out of here.
But his lyrics. I don't think he really said it. That's I don't know, but this said. Nigga do rap, be rapping some true shit, though.
Get
I don't know.
The fuck out of here. No.
But he never.
No. If
but
y'all co-signed that line right there.
He said that we used to date. He never said he fucks SZA.
I don't care, Maddox.
In the words of Maddox B.
That's classic shit.
If he fucks SZA, he could have said it on the track.
And the song is called Mr. Right Now. And she would
that nigga.
That's some funny shit. That's some sad shit,
really,
my nigga.
Fucked.
So, but
if he really, no, if he really,
that's what he said.
Fucked. Now I've fucked chicks to their own music, but I've never.
I'm just saying, bro.
We got a couple. He of said guests
we used to date.
What is happening right now?
We got a couple guests coming up.
He said we used to date.
What you want to listen to? Put your shit on. But I did. But honestly, all jokes aside, though, I wouldn't tell a chick that I smashed her, especially in that moment.
We don't do that.
That's savage, bro.
We don't talk. To the other, like, he's talking to another chick about who he smashed.
Females are worse, though.
We do not talk to other dudes about who we smashed.
Yes, y'all do. Fuck out of here. Yes, y'all do. What are you talking
about? Damn, your girls really don't fuck with you. They be telling you all the niggas they smashed.
Not my girls.
You the only one co-signing it. No.
What are you talking about?
That's like.
Y'all do nut shit like that. Y'all are known to be the nuttiest of nuts.
I don't. Okay, so I'm going to walk up to the dude I'm smashing while we laid up. Like, and then you listening to dude? Yeah, I smashed him too. But then, let that shit play.
And then if we fuck up, we a little dick ass nigga too on top of it.
No.
Everybody's a little dick ass nigga.
It's not the same, yo. But I did do some shit like that in high school, though. I had two whole boyfriends.
Tell the story. No, you opened it up now. Pause. Go ahead, tell the story. What did you do at Piscataway High?
Stop. Home of the Chiefs. Come on. Why were you home really thought this? Oh, God. All right. I was dating two dudes. I was dating two dudes, and I was riding to school. Yeah, no, different schools. So I'm riding.
Where's the other one from?
Chill. I'm riding to school with my dude, and I'm playing the other dude's mixtape. It was popping, though. Like, it was already in my CD player. It was 2006.
Slimy ass motherfucker.
I really was sorry about that. I really felt really bad about that for a long time.
She pumped the also go. Did you tell him, though?
The shit probably was good.
He knew he wasn't stupid.
And she liked the fucking mixtape.
He had my MySpace password. He was like, I heard that song on his MySpace. I was like, I mean, it's popping, though, right?
Man, shout out to Shay C Vibes, man.
That nigga AKA, went into investigation mode.
Hold on. Yeah. A.K.A. the owner of Savage Bartending LLC.
That was like 15 years ago.
Yo, he had to dig to find that.
Oh,
yo.
My God.
MySpace?
I can't believe
how
I said
that. How the fuck did he find that
no,
shit?
No. This was back in high school. Spot.
Like, yo, he went on MySpace Music, bro. Yeah.
I've never been on MySpace.
It's not easy to find an artist, bro. You have to know the artist already.
I'm so glad I've grown up. I've grown up, guys.
It wasn't like Instagram.
So she can't say shit because that right there shows that females are way worse than.
I was freaking 17. Yeah, I was.
Aaliyah was also 17 when she married R. Kelly. I'm just saying.
No, well, I don't even think she
you
was 17.
You know who else made a hit record at 17?
Jay
Sloan made a fucking record at 17, motherfuckers. Try this, nigga. I'm just saying. Man, with that being said, man, right now, man, we're going to get into some new music, man. We're going to get into a new video.
Let's get
man.
Into
actually,
that.
Actually, we're going to get into a new
pause.
Video, man.
I'm going to say pause.
Matter
the first
fact,
time.
This is what I'm going to do, man.
Let's get into that pause.
Hold on. We're going to allow the brother right over here. Again, this is Dose Do Money.
Yes, sir.
Get into your new video. Pause, man. Introduce your new video and who it's featuring and everything. And we're going to get into this right quick.
No doubt, man. This is Dose Do Money, man. We got a new single off the album Dollar Baby dropping October 30th. You know what I mean? This song is called Go Gettaz. Featuring Inglewood, South Central Zone, El Prez. El Prez de la on IG. Just go get us, Dollar Baby, Dose the Money.
Go get us, man. Shout out to Inglewood, man. Bang.
Shout out to Inglewood.
Always.
Inglewood thing. Shout out to Cap. Yeah. Dose. Do money, motherfucker. Yo, Prez, you already know what it is. We come back with another one, bro. Yeah. I got an oral that'll kill the blind. Sipping tangerine extract and prepping for a late night. A couple shorties on speed dial with freak styles. 3 mile radius to out of town sweets, child. Writing proverbs like corporate predicates. Night airs got me back in my earth, just in my element. Swimming through sirens like water. I'm on fire to your detriment. My feature presentations are so excellent. This no JK, followed by an element. I read the green like I'm Mexican. Go dumb as a brick. When I recite it, I remain quite intelligent. Bagging raps and then selling shit. So bear witness as the fabrics compliment the savage. Had a porn actress do acrobatics all up on my mattress. Hold on, baby, let me dust the marijuana ashes. No need to pass me the torch, I got my match. Smoke purr, smoke bay, smoke sour, smoke kush. Ride around town, bag a shorty if she look. I do money, I get it in. I do my thing, it's so amazing. Bread, broccoli, butter, cheddar, nothing in the world tastes better. Set pussy, I'ma get her wetter. A money, make it straight, go get her.
We all are fame like Joe Namath and Bo Jackson. From South Central to New Jersey, we stay taxing. Got a chick in the birds, but yeah, she about that action. Took her down at the London, but met her at the Grafton. How you close to the street, but never gaining traction? Taking photos in front of homes that ain't your mansion. We don't front for the gram, boy, we stack the back end. We enslaving our masses, spinning Andrew Jackson. Throw them high in the air and hit a lady's back end. With some call, rep a operations, we call it rapping. What you niggas call eating, we call it snacking. And I ain't resting till I hit, I brings truck back. It's due money, plus sell prayers, it's new money. We do dirt and don't get caught like you dummies. We do work, just ask your girl who do it better. Doing it well like LL, cause I'm a go-getter. In a race for the cheese, like brass for the cheddar. On a dame dash for the Z's, like Jay and Rockefeller. Back when I started, I knew this life was forever. So when they try to change my mind, I just change the weather. More change for my time, dollars for the cents. More diamonds in the chain, money on the ring. It's the return of the black president. So fuck all of that struggling, let's go and flip some tough.
Smoke purse, smoke haze, smoke sour, smoke kush. Ride around town, bag a shorty if she look. I do money, I get it in. I do my thing, it's so amazing. Bread, broccoli, butter, cheddar, nothing in the world tastes better. Said pussy, I'ma get her wetter. My money, make it straight, go get her. Playing chess on an Android with all my pieces. AI ain't got shit on the guy. I'm the Phoenix. Aficionado, expert, specialist, elitist. Keep getting these red bones pregnant. Check the pieces. Yeah, I don't date, prefer to hang like an ornament. Think she broke a heart full of gold trying to dig for the shit. Mind full of big bands, Caribbean voyages. Sun kissed bad bitches, Ferraris, Maybachs, Porsches. This a 40 or some OE, that old English. I cop two and then sit the shit. Isn't it amazing? Yeah, how I saw myself. Must not have known how much I'm used to being by myself. I grind, proceed as such, with the cars life dealt. Now I'm puffing trees and coordinating menage a trois. Draped in designer, yeah, what you thought this was. Money, clothes, hoes, yeah, and love, all of the above, nigga.
Red, broccoli, butter, cheddar, nothing in the world tastes better. Set pussy, I'ma get her wetter. My money, make it straight, go get her.
Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. That was our video of the week. None other than Dose Do Money featuring L. Prez.
Yes, sir.
Go get us.
Yes, sir.
Go fresh off us. That new album, you know what I mean? Well, the new album drops on the 30th, correct?
Yep, Dollar Baby.
Dollar Baby, right?
Yes, sir.
Go get that. All streaming platforms, baby.
Yep.
So
yes,
we
sir.
Appreciate you coming back, man.
Thank
pause.
You, man. Thank you, man.
You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? Hold on, brother. Here, you know what I mean? We appreciate you coming back, man. So the purpose of us bringing you back, man, is to, you know, big you up and give you your flowers while you can smell them, man. You was our first guest, and you have a project coming up, man. We want to highlight our local up-and-coming talent. And tell everybody about your album, man, Dollar Baby, man, when it's dropping, like you already said on the 30th. Where they can cop it and who's guest featured on it.
Most definitely, man. Well, Dollar Baby, it's an album that I've been working on since August of 2018. It'll be dropping on Friday, October the 30th. And, you know what I mean? I've been working on this album. It's going to be featuring a lot of artists. Shotgun Shook, Geechee Gotti, KD Young Cocky from The Shy, Slitter from The Shy. We also have Vucci P from TSF. Salute. You know what I mean, to TSF. We also have L. Prez on the album. On the production side, we have Bulletproof. We have Mob Career, Chevy Guat from The Shy. That's my bro out there in The Shy. Salute, Southside Chicago. We also have myself on it and Master Roshi. Master Roshi from Southern California.
Speaking of that video with L. Prez, man, y'all was in front of a legendary spot.
I was going to ask that. Did you get some donuts?
Nah, but I got In-N-Out Burger the night before, you know what I mean? In-N-Out Burger might be the best fast food burger I've ever gotten, you know what I mean?
Everybody keeps saying that.
It was good.
In-N-Out is...
You had an In-N-Out Burger?
Me and my homegirl, shout out to Z, she in the building too. On her birthday, we went to Cali, and we went to In-N-Out Burger, I think, three times that trip.
You know who was In-N-Out?
Four.
You know who was In-N-Out, man? Dej Lo's career.
Shut up.
But that's neither here nor there, man. But,
we got the donuts, too.
If y'all saw the video, man, Randy's Donuts, did you have the donuts?
Yes, we got the donuts.
So was they slam? Was
they
good?
Was slam, and I think that's the last place we went before we got on the fucking flight.
Were they better than Krispy Kreme's?
Yes.
Yo, you can talk. Go ahead. Talk your shit, Queen.
Chicago,
yo, man. All we did was eat. First of all, we got off the flight, went to the dispensary, stocked up for the Black Friday sale, and all we did was eat.
Yo, dispensaries be having them sales on deck.
It was great.
Spencer's?
Yes, what? They always got sales on deck. I remember when I went to Vegas and I got two But I get two. I got two A's for like 35 or 40 bucks.
Man, we getting on the.
I got three A's for like 40 bucks. They was giving two A's for free.
Get back to our guest, man. Let's get back to our guest.
That shit was wild, man. I was like, yo.
So, like I said, man, you was in front of a legendary spot, man. How did it feel? Was that your first time in that part of like South Central the Inglewood area, like legendary spot like that? How did it feel just to shoot a video in front of such a legendary spot?
Hey, man, first of all, that was my first time in L.A.
That was your first time in L.A.?
Yeah, man. And me and Matt, we were discussing it a few days ago, you know what I mean? We was cooling in before, you know what I mean? We was talking about it. And honestly, I'll tell you right now, man, L.A., it's like it's a whole other world, dog. And it's like the air is different, you know what I mean? It's like a lot of mountains. When I landed there, I rented a car, and I was driving through Pasadena and everything because my hotel was in Pomona. And it was like it was a whole other planet, it felt like. But it felt like Jersey, though. It was just different.
Jersey gets a lot of love out there in L.A., too, man.
Yeah, man. Yep. Most definitely.
I've been out there two times, and both times. Like, I loved it. I loved it, and I didn't love it. It was just because I had to be on my toes because I went out there for different purposes. Like, I went to the Jordan Down Projects out Watts.
Yeah.
You know, the birthplace of Grape Street. So I went out there to pay homage. You know what I mean? Watts up. I went out there. We call that our Mecca. Shout out to, you know, Sunday was 10 Trade Day, man. That was National Grape Street Day, man. But that's neither here nor there.
All right, salute to you, man.
You know what I mean? But I went out there for that, and then I went there for the when Nipsey passed or whatever, too.
Rest in peace,
but,
man.
That's something I never spoke. But I went out there or whatever. And it was just you also have to watch yourself being from out of state and being connected with a gang movement and – trying to pay homage to the West Coast also because, yeah, we're out there and they showing us love.
Yeah.
Our side is showing us love. But I also had to be mindful, like, I'm moving around a certain thing, like, yo, fam, like, we showing you with us. But you just can't walk over this motherfucker, man. So when you shot these videos, this was part, last time we talked to you, this was part of your little tour you was taking, correct?
Yeah. I went to Chicago, Houston, road tripped it from Houston to Dallas. Shout out to Terry from Dallas Global. Hey. I had you on the vlog.
Yeah. Shout out to the vlog, man. Yeah, I didn't even know. I called this brother asking him a question about something.
Yeah, day before I flew to L.A., I was at Dallas Global, and I was with Terry and DJ Loud. And then you called in because we was talking about some business, and then he was also seeing how I was doing. I respect that, too, brother.
Yeah, that's definitely part of my left. You know what I mean?
You good. And you know what I mean? And you know what I mean? Terry from Dallas Global, that's big bro and shit, man. He showed me hella love out in Dallas. But I mean, y'all linked this shit. Y'all in the vlog,
Yeah, man, definitely, man. Before I turn over to my co-host, man, listen, I'm not going to lie, man. Listen, man, the one song that catches my attention that I never thought I would like is that shit with Vucci P.
Yeah. Right? I know, yeah.
This nigga's voice, you was mentioning him on the last podcast, right?
Yeah.
I didn't hear the song. Vucci you would tell me about him, the whole, was it TSF?
TSF.
All right, the whole movement.
TSF business.
Okay. This bro, he's unique.
that's my name.
He's unique. But yo, I bumped that shit so many times in a row. It's one of them songs, like, I could see this shit being a fucking hit.
Mm-hmm. We was playing in the club in Houston, man. Shout out to DJ Lefty. He was playing at the club at the Daiquiri Bar, Nolan's, in Houston, and they was loving it. Yeah, I mean, hell yeah.
So dope.
Shout out to Vucci, TSF, TSF Business, Sauce with the Wings, all that. Man.
I want to know about Side Nigga Woes.
Side Nigga Woes? How you know about Side Nigga? Oh, you saw the track.
Yes, I did. You know I do my research.
Side Nigga Woes?
SM Dubs. SM Dubs. Side Nigga Woes.
I want to know about Side Nigga Woes.
That's actually.
Hold on.
All right.
You got some woes?
We getting spicy.
You got a drink.
Sorrows.
The song. Basically, Side Nigga Woes, that's off the album. That's honestly, if not Go Getters, is my favorite song off the album. That song, essentially, it's like, you know what I mean? It's R&B. I'm singing through two-thirds of it.
Fuck
like,
R&B, by the way.
I'm actually singing, you know what I mean? I'm on my Keith Sweat, Ty Dolla, you know what I mean? I'm on that type of vibe with the song. The beat, I made the beat, too. It's on some DJ Wildcat, G-Funk shit. But it's basically about the autobiography of being a side nigga. Me, you know what I mean? I was kind of grimy back in the days, man. Like, you know what I mean? So I'm telling, like, the autobiography of me sneaking into the crib. You know what
sidebar,
I mean?
Sidebar, man. There's nothing wrong with being a side nigga. Side nigga is a good situation.
Oh, it's the autobiography. It's called Side Nigga Woes. It's the autobiography of being a side nigga. But it's fun. You know what I mean? It's a fun song. But it's like, you know what I mean? You'll be playing that, you'll be thinking, damn, like, she was a bad chick calling me through when her man was at work. Like, it's that type of song.
Sheesh, you know what I mean? Man, that's what y'all be rapping about.
That song, is lit, man.
I heard it. Yeah, we was playing the beat.
I got a couple of side nigga woes going on right now.
Oh, my God.
Lit. I mean, but they married, too. So, I mean, it makes for a win-win. I'm just saying,
man. You got someone flew on the side of
you. Oh, man. Damn fly. Don't hit me, nigga. Just don't hit me. Don't pull a fucking wallow out this bitch, man. But how many songs you got on the project?
On the project? Well, the thing is, the track list kind of got edited. I mean, right now we're sitting at 13 songs because we have an intro. You know what I mean? We're working on the intro for the album. So that, and then, you know what I mean, plus some other things. It's probably going to be like 13 songs. We doing nothing but adding to it. Dre Valentino, he's like the executive engineer of the album. Okay. Shout out to Onyx Studios, previously known as Studio 9. He has essentially, you know what I mean, worked with me with the vision of the sonicness in the album and with the songs, including Shock from Chicago. And, you know what I mean, it's looking like it's going to be 13 songs.
13?
Yeah.
Okay. You said the 30th, correct?
The 30th, man. Listen, man, I'm so excited, bro. Like, I remember flying out to Chicago.
I remember when you left, man. You left, I think.
I didn't even meet you back then, my nigga.
Yeah.
You talking about the tour.
I thought you were talking about when I flew out to Chicago the first
time.
Okay.
You're right. Yeah, when we flew out for the tour, yeah. You know what I mean? And this man actually was checking on me when I was out there, when I was in Atlanta too.
I think I called you. You was damn near in every city when I called you. I called you when you first left. And then
Houston.
He was checking on me when I was Dallas. And then I think the only time I might not have talked to you when you was in L.A. I might have. I don't know. I can't remember, man. I drink a lot of Henny. My fault. I don't smoke nothing,
bro.
I drink a lot of Henny, man.
But part of what I was saying, with the other flight that we were talking about that we had mistaken it for was in 2018, I was out in Vegas, and I started working with Chevy Guap. He's the same dude that did the beat for El Dorado, Flow Ride, Hop On It. Like, that's my dog right there. And I flew out to Chicago, Southside, the first time, and I went to Shock House Studios, this dude named Shock, and we worked on El Dorado. You know what I mean? I'll be releasing that footage before the release of the album, but it was like, that was when I decided to really invest in myself and venture outside of my state and be like, you know what? I'm going to do this. I have the money. Should I commit? I'm like, yeah, man, I'm dose, nigga. You know what I'm saying? And I flew out. And I flew out, and I've been to Chicago another time since. Shout out to Slitta and Katie and Cocky. Actually, I've been out to Chicago twice since then, you know what I mean, to do the Hop On It video, you know what I mean? Shout out to JY the Visionary, you know what I mean?
And this damn fly getting on my fucking nerves. I'm about to fuck some shit about this fucking fly getting on my nerves, Rick. About to break some shit out this bitch. It's on my head, nigga. Man, fuck.
Flying around and shit. But anyways, man. But yeah, for real, like, when it comes to the album, man, like, it definitely, it's been a long time coming, you know what I mean? It's taken about 2 years and 2 months to make this album. 13 songs I truly believe are like a good contribution to hip hop, man.
Definitely, brother.
That sounds like a solid
album.
Shoot,
I heard a song that y'all when y'all hear it. Shit.
What's the name of it so we can look out for?
Gather Round. It be sounding like some Griselda shit, yeah.
When y'all hear that? Mm.
Listen, I get busy, bro. I be rapping on trappies. Y'all don't know, man. I've been doing this shit for like 11 years, man. I can rap.
Just look out. October 30th.
Y'all heard Flo Rida. I get
busy.
Listen
to that.
What track is the one that you put me on?
They see I'm like some small fries.
What track is the one you put me on?
That's my shit, bro.
What track is the one you put me on?
Oh, the track that I put you on? Shit, man. We did the Triumph remix, man. We the next Meth and Red, man.
Didn't make the cut. But, in the archives.
Yeah, we here promoting the Dollar Baby album and everything. But I also want to big up your Passing Fly Hour and everything, man. You've had some big interviews, you know.
Thank you, bro.
Everyone from myself to myself. Shit.
G-Money.
And myself.
Shout out to Queens Flip, I mean, G-Money.
But no, he's had everyone from... G Money from Flip the Script podcast, OG Wildcat, founders of the UBN East Coast Bloods, to a slew of porn stars.
Look at you and your words today.
This is what I do.
Tell
man.
Me fucking go.
I started paying attention to my kids' elementary school work.
Virtual learning.
Yeah, I mean, so are you currently? I haven't seen anything lately with the Pass the Fly Hour. What's currently going on with that? Is that still in the works or what's going on?
Most definitely. I'm actually, the thing is with the Passing Fly Hour, it's something that I actually just started out of just the fun of doing it. I mean, Wildcat was someone.
And he drinks a 40 live on in the middle of the.
I was trying to slow down on the 40s though and shit. But yeah, you're right, man. I'd be sipping on the 40, you know what I mean? And the thing was, it started as just like, you know what I mean, just me reaching out to people who I fuck with already off the strength. And it's become something that, you know what I mean, YouTube, because the thing is, I do be interviewing porn stars and some of them, you know what I mean, they be flashing the titties and shit.
Yeah,
and YouTube
flashing was like titties and making it clap. Ass. And yeah, I'm not talking about YouTube, with their hands. Like, yeah, I'm not talking YouTube, about with their hands.
At all.
Yeah, man. And YouTube has given me some difficulty. So we on Patreon now. And the thing is, with that, like, I kind of had to take a step back and figure, all right, because I have the album going on. I'm like, how am I going to get this correct? So I decided to, you know what I mean, do 10 episode seasons. So I'm going to try to do season 2. That's going to be November and December. 10 guests. I have 2 locked in right now. Like 2 or 3 more in the works. We got Shay in the works for an episode 2.
Oh, shout out to Shay C Vibes.
Shout out to Shay Vibes, you know what I'm saying? And then I'll probably do season 3 around like March, April of 21. So, you know what I mean? I'm trying to bring more of a variety this coming season. We have some pro athletes in the talks right now, including your run-of-the-mill porn stars. You know what I'm saying? We got a few. I'm not going to name, fellas.
We got to keep the porn stars.
You know what I mean?
That's
we got,
like, 2 in the works.
You know what I mean?
I got a couple of videos Shaolin around out there, man.
A possible Shaolin monk is going to be on the next season. And also some MMA fighters and also some action film stars, some punk rock artists.
That's lit.
Pro wrestlers. You know what I mean? We got a few different. I'm trying to make it more of a variety this season. So it'll definitely be a fun time.
So outside of the pass and fly hour and your album coming up, what else you got going on? You have anything else going on?
I got a son on the way, bro.
Oh, woo!
Hey.
I heard your son got a godfather too.
Yeah, man, Maddox gonna be the godfather of my son. Tyson.
Oh, shit!
The godfather in the building.
Oh, you know what? First thing I gotta say is, man, I gotta give my boy Dose like all the fucking flowers right now, man. Like, I appreciate that.
No doubt, that's my brother,
oh,
man.
Shit, niggas about to get sentimental. Yeah.
I don't want to get too emotional to be, and all
you know
that.
I mean, baby mother, aka my girlfriend.
Yeah,
no,
slap it up. There we go, there Brianna, we go, man. There we go, too, man. Shout out to B, man. There we go,
lady.
She on the iPhone.
Miss Do Money in the building. Miss Do Money in the building.
You know what I'm saying?
But yeah, it's an honor, man. It's nothing but an honor.
So you got a son. You got an album.
Yeah.
You got Pass and Fly season 2 coming up.
Yeah, man.
But you need those bars coming
up. Open it up.
Hey, I'm ready. And listen, y'all. Anyone who saw the previous one, I wrote that verse in 30 minutes.
Nah, there ain't no excuses, my nigga.
This is going
to
be a freestyle today.
None of that shit,
I'm going to show y'all that I get down. You know what I mean?
He being humble, yo. He wrote that shit in 15.
I guess busy, bro.
I'm just trying to tell you, so.
He wrote that shit in the 15. He rapped the other in the other 15, but he wrote the verse in 15.
But,
yeah, and
well, I ain't gonna say in case you don't know, because you know you're the first person to bless the mic. Pause.
Right.
I'm sorry. That was a good
one. That was a good one.
But you know,
I had to give him that.
We got a tradition up here at Loggic Unplugged podcast. You know,
sure.
The hot box. Pause. You started the hot box.
I guess so.
You blessed
did,
the hot
bro.
Box.
Inaugural
first
guest. You know
I mean,
yeah.
You're the only person that did better than me. Like, I be spitting in my head. You know what I mean? But, you know, every time I watch
new episode, Red, Ab, you know what I'm saying? We the new Metro Red.
Nah, but shout out to our engineer, Roderick Boyd, over here, Studio B856, man. You know,
shout outs, man.
Rod, man, can we get a beat whenever you ready over there, back there, brother?
My mic's up.
Studio B, man.
Pass and Fly in the building,
give
bro.
Me Pass and Fly hour, man. Dollar Baby
got
album.
Got Dose Do Money in here.
Yes,
got
sir.
Got
yes,
Chasey
sir.
Vibes. Got Chase. You know what I'm saying? We over here, man. Get this beat started.
Yeah. You already know what time it is, bro. Pass and Fly business. Dollar Baby album, 1030-1030. Shout out to 732-973-201-862-856-908. You know what it is. Yeah, you talking about the D.O. Dollar. I don't give a fuck about plays. Dollars, man, I got some followers. You know what it is.
Yeah, I be rocking loose fits. I rule Chris. I do this until the crew lit. You don't want to fuck with me because I come through with the armory. My name is Dose the Money. I'm from the garden. Instead of picking flowers, I was getting hard, man. Whipping up the whammy in the kitchen. I don't give a fuck. Yeah, I don't need a Smith and Wesson. I got the lyrical antidote. Y'all niggas all just jokes. I'm here with King Ab. Y'all niggas try to come through with my flow. I'll leave you laying down. Get down and lay down. I'm like a paper soldier. Yeah, man, shout out to Dean Dash. He taught me how to get the money and then pass and fly. Yeah, man, this no lie. I don't give a fuck, man. I used to go by Eddie I. Now my name is Wells. Matter of fact, it's EO Dollar Sign. I don't give a fuck. Make a girl wet like a motherfucking Poland Spring. Check out the diamond
off
ring.
The
matter
top.
Of fact,
off
it's
top,
all gold.
Yeah. First nigga to go off the top with it, man.
I know it is. For real, I was the first to go off the top with this shit.
First to go off the top, man. Baby.
Shout out to Dose Do Money, man. Dose Do Money, man.
Done with it.
Shout out to Dollar Baby album, October 30th. All streaming platforms. You know what I mean? Shout out to Matic Beats over here.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean? Shout out to Shacy Vibes.
Matic Beats, Shacy Vibes.
You know what I mean? Shout out to Dose Do Money.
You already know, man. Passive Fly thing in this bitch. You already know,
I mean,
man.
That's Logic Unplugged podcast.
10, baby.
That's Logic Unplugged with two motherfucking G's. That's the end of episode 10. And we out this motherfucker.
Make history.
Holla at us. Peace.
Peace.
Cash money with the white tee and the soldier rag. We going ultra black. Unapologetically black. The opposite of Doja Cat. Michael Black's in black. We going ultra black. I got a toast to that. We don't.